One day, a 25-year-old patient with pain and swelling in the right knee called my office to make an appointment. He recently changed his sexual partner, then in a few days he developed a sexually transmitted disease. He called his primary care physician, got treatment, felt better, but 3 weeks after the initial infection, he woke up one morning with pain, swelling of the right knee. He called again his primary care physician and he was told to call a rheumatologist. After a short discussion with the patient, I was able to diagnose him with reactive arthritis.
Rheumatologistoncall.com.
In this lecture, we'll discuss about what is reactive arthritis, what infections can cause reactive arthritis, and what are the most common signs of reactive arthritis. Reactive arthritis is an inflammatory arthritis induced by an infection, usually in the gut or the urogenital area. Most of the times, it happens within 4 weeks from the initial infection. Patients are young, between 20 and 40 years old. In majority of cases, only one joint or just a few joints are affected. Most frequently, one knee or one ankle is affected. Some patients are genetically predisposed to develop reactive arthritis. Let me explain you that. 60 to 80% of patients with reactive arthritis, they actually have a positive HLA-B27, which may increase their risk to develop this disease. If you want to know more about HLA-B27, what it is, and how can this one relate to different forms of inflammatory arthritis, watch this video in my channel. What infections can cause reactive arthritis? Bacteria, viruses, or parasites that cause infections in the gut or urogenital areas can cause reactive arthritis. Let me give you a few examples. Bacteria that cause sexually transmitted disease, such as chlamydia trachomatis or neisseria gonorrhea, are commonly known to cause reactive arthritis. Viruses like HIV that can also be sexually transmitted. Now, bacteria, viruses, and parasites that cause gut infections are also commonly known to cause reactive arthritis. Let me give you a few examples. Salmonella, Shigella, Yersinia, Campylobacter, Clostridium difficile, or parasites like Giardia, or viruses like hepatitis C. Patients that will get a tick bite and get infected with Borrelia, the tick that can cause Lyme disease, can also develop a reactive arthritis. However, in 40% of cases, the infectious agent cannot be identified. What are the most common signs and symptoms of reactive arthritis? Number one is joint pain. Most of the time, reactive arthritis will affect big joints or joints on one side of the body, usually 1 to 2 joints. The ankles, the knees, the hips are frequently affected. The wrist and digits can also be affected in 50% of patients. The joints can be red, swollen, stiff, and warm. All of these are signs of inflammation. 40% of patients can have pain in the lower back or sacroiliac joints. The inflammation in that area is usually on one side, and it's called sacroiliitis. Tendonitis. Tendonitis or enthesitis, it's an inflammation of the tendons or the enthesis. The most common tendons affected are the Achilles tendon, and patients will have pain, redness, and will be very sensitive to touch. Some patients can develop plantar fasciitis, which is another type of inflammation of the plantar fascia. Low-grade fever. Fever is a frequent sign of infection. When you have fever and arthritis, the initial evaluation should rule out an infection. Skin, mucosa, and nails involvement. Patients with reactive arthritis can have mucosa and skin around the genital organs affected. For example, they can have balanitis, keratoderma balanitis, or can develop painful nodules under the skin that we call erythema nodosum. Some patients can have oral sores or ulcerations. Inflammation or infections in the urogenital area that may involve the prostate, the urethra, the urinary bladder or vagina are also common. Gut infections. Inflammation or infection of the gut can also involve the small or the large intestine, and they can also cause reactive arthritis. Many bacteria in the gut, for example, Clostridium difficile, can cause reactive arthritis. Eyes involvement. Conjunctivitis is an infection or an inflammation of the conjunctiva, which is the outer part of the eyes. About 60% of patients with reactive arthritis can also have conjunctivitis. Uveitis is an inflammation of the interior chamber of the eyes, and it is seen more frequently in patients with an HLA-B27 positive, and most of the time will affect just one eye. Heart involvement. Some infections, for example Lyme disease, but also others, can affect the heart, and patients can develop chest pain, shortness of breath, or even fluid around their heart. In rare cases, patients can develop heart blocks or inflammation of the aorta. In my next video, I will discuss how to make a diagnosis and how to treat reactive arthritis. Remember, these lectures are just for educational purpose. They're not supposed to give you medical advice. You should always contact and discuss your clinical situation with a physician. If you like the content of these educational videos, please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for being here. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you soon.
RheumatologistOnCall.com